Welcome to Hopkinton High School for first round playoff action. It's Hopkinton Hillers softball on HCAM. And today, the six-seeded Hopkinton Hillers, who are 17-3, take on the 11-seeded Plymouth South Panthers. Plymouth South is 13-7 on the season and looking for the upset here today in Hillertown, but they will certainly have their work cut out for them as the Hillers have had a good amount of time off. And Bree Mirabli is set to go as the first hitter of the game. Danielle LaRanger steps in, the center fielder. And the first pitch is outside, 1-0 on LaRanger. It is a beautiful sunny day here in Hillertown. Temperatures in the high 70s. There's a swinging strike. And that is actually going to make the count 0-2. That first pitch was actually a strike there. Apologize for that. We'll take a look at the Plymouth South lineup in just a moment as Mirabli set to deliver. And there it is, strike three, out number one. Shannon Colbert, the shortstop, will step in. The lineup for Plymouth South, you just saw Danielle LaRanger strike out. Shannon Colbert stepping in now, the shortstop. Jessica White due up next, the first baseman. Abigail Conley, the designated player in the cleanup role. Alyssa Dillon, the third baseman, batting fifth. There's strike one to Colbert. Victoria Delph, the catcher, hitting sixth. Hannah Bailey, the left fielder, hitting seventh. Sarah Eaton, the second baseman, hitting eighth. Caroline LaRanger, the right fielder, hitting ninth. There's strike two. 0-2 to Colbert. Good start so far for Mirabli. Struck out the first hitter. As that one's fouled away. The Hillers were supposed to play this game yesterday, but rain affected that. So if the Hillers win here today, they will pick things back up tomorrow. The winner of this game will go on to play Walpole. As that pitch is just outside. And the Hillers would have the home field advantage in that matchup. As this one's on the ground, third base side and foul. Count will remain 1-2. Line up and the pitch, that one's foul. In fact, either of these teams, Hopkinton or Plymouth South, whoever wins this game will host Walpole. That one's foul. Walpole got a 8-5 upset over third seeded Marshfield. Marshfield was 17-1 heading into that game. Walpole was 11-9. And Walpole pulled off the stunning upset. This is up the middle, gloved by the shortstop. Throw to first, not a problem. 6-3 goes Colbert, two away. And now Jessica White will come up to the plate. And of course, the Hopkinton Hillers compete out of the South Division I bracket. Take you around the bracket in just a moment to let you know who's left standing. Mirabli deals. There's strike one to the first baseman, Jessica White. On the other side of the bracket, Silver Lake got a victory to advance as that pitch is just outside over Mansfield, 5-0, and then Milford beat New Bedford, 9-2 to advance to play Silver Lake. That game's happening right now as well, as there's a strike. Bridgewater, Raynham, and Plymouth North are going at it in first round action. Plymouth North beat Dartmouth in the preliminaries, 8-5. Bridgewater, Raynham had the bye round. As there's strike three, and Plymouth South will go down 1-2-3 in the top half of the first. The Hopkinton Hillers coming up on the bottom of the first. It is a scoreless game here in Hillertown. Welcome back to Hopkinton High School, bottom of the first. The Hillers coming up, and they will be battling against Emily Spillane, the pitcher for Plymouth South. Lily Morningstar set to step in. Let's take a look at the Hillers' batting order. Lily Morningstar, the center fielder, starting things off. Katie Holly, the right fielder, batting second. Molly Bennett, the shortstop, hitting third. Kate Welzel, the catcher, is in the cleanup role as that bunt goes foul. Heather Holly, the designated player, hitting fifth. Bree Mirabli, the pitcher, hitting sixth. Lindsay Whittles, the left fielder, hitting seventh. Isabel Holden, the first baseman, hitting eighth. Emily Whalen, the second baseman, hitting ninth. Emma Murphy is the third baseman, and she is the odd man out of the batting order. We'll get you the Plymouth South Diamond in just a moment. As that pitch is inside. 0-2. Emily Spillane on the plate for Plymouth South. Victoria Delph behind the plate. Jessica White is the first baseman. Sarah Eaton, the second baseman. Shannon Colbert, the shortstop. Alyssa Dillon, the third baseman. The windup and the pitch on the ground, third base side. Gloved at third base, throw to first, no problem. 5-3 there for Morningstar. That'll bring up Katie Holly. From left to right, Hannah Bailey, Danielle LaRanger, and Caroline LaRanger for Plymouth South. As Katie Holly steps in. Miller's hoping to get some early momentum here. And there's a bunt up the middle, gloved by the pitcher, throw to first, not a problem. 1-3 goes Holly. And now Molly Bennett to the plate. Blaine set to deal. That one inside. Wind up and the pitch, fouled away. Set to deal. There's a swinging strike. Spillane deals. Upstairs. And now Molly Bennett will have a chat with head coach Kylie Murray. Plymouth South out of the Atlantic Coast Pilgrim League. As there's strike number three, and that'll retire the side on the bottom of the first. To the top of the second we go. It's a scoreless playoff game between Plymouth South and Hopkinton. Top half of the second inning. Let's take a look at the Hopkinton Hillers field. On the mound is Bree Mirabli, who has just been sensational all season long. Kate Welzel behind the plate. Isabel Holden at first base. Emily Whalen at second base. Molly Bennett at shortstop. Emma Murphy at third base as the hitter Abigail Conley steps in and awaits the Bree Mirabli pitch. Okay, the outfield in just a moment as the first pitch in there for a strike. From left to right, Lindsay Whittles, Lily Morningstar, and Katie Holly. Due up this inning for Plymouth South, Abigail Conley, Alyssa Dillon as that pitch is in there, and Victoria Delph. That one up high. We'll get you the rest of the brackets in just a moment. That'll make the count 2-2. Taking a look at the brackets, we let you know that Silver Lake and Milford, they are in the semifinals as their strike three. Third strike out of the game for Mirabli. That'll bring up Alyssa Dillon to the plate. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. So the other matchups going on today, Bridgewater Raynham, who's the fourth seed, taking on Plymouth North. Plymouth North is the 20th seed, as there's a strike. They are playing over at Bridgewater Raynham. Bishop Feehan is in action at Bishop Feehan. They're the fifth seed, 17-3. They're up against Braintree, as there's a strike three. And that is two strikeouts in the second inning. Four overall for Mirabli. Braintree is the 12th seed. They're 13-7. Then another game going on today is Taunton and King Philip. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. Taunton, the second seed, 21-1. King Philip, the seventh seed, 18-4. And there's strike two. And the winner of this game would play Walpole tomorrow. And whoever wins this game will have home field advantage tomorrow. Fouled away. So the advantage for Walpole is having a couple days off before your next game. Meanwhile, whoever wins here is going to have to play the very next day, but Mirabli just struck out the side as there's strike three on Victoria Delph. Fifth strikeout of the game for Mirabli. We head to the bottom of the second. It's a scoreless game here in Hopkinton. Hopkinton Hiller is coming back up to the plate in the bottom of the second. Due up are the 4, 5, and 6 hitters, Kate Welzel, Heather Holly, and Bree Mirabli. Hopkinton Hiller's playoff softball. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. Emily Splain set to deliver to Kate Welzel. That pitch up high, 1-0. First game of the postseason for the Hillers. And they've actually had almost a week off with the rainout that happened on Sunday. There's a strike. 1-1. This game originally supposed to take place yesterday, and kind of a disadvantage for these teams because whoever wins has to play tomorrow against a team that has had a couple days off. There's another strike. But right now, the only thing on the minds of these two teams is this game right here. Splain deals. There's a strike. Throw down to first in time. Second strikeout of the game for Spillane. That'll bring up Heather Holly. There's a strike. 0-1. Light up and the pitch, fouled away. The 0-2 pitch. That's rocketed foul. Set to deliver. Strike three, throw down to first, is going to get away, and Heather Holly will be safe. Safe on the error. So one on with one out. Bree Mirabli to the plate. Big break there for the Hillers. Rabley's been hitting well as of late. That pitch down low. Rabley hitting a 327 on the season. Has really hit well as of late. That one down low. 20 RBIs on the season for Mirabli. That one's fouled away into the Hillers dugout area. Six doubles and four triples for Mirabli. She's actually tied for the lead in doubles and leading the team in triples. Wind up and the pitch upstairs. Every season that's passed by, she's just become more and more of a complete player. It's Blaine Deals. That's upstairs. Mirabli draws the walk. Heather Holly up to second. Mirabli up to first. Lindsay Whittles to the plate. We're going to have a pinch runner for the Hillers. Coming in a pinch run is Katie Sylvester for Mirabli. And that is going to hit Whittles in the back, taking one for the team, and the bases are loaded with one out for the Hillers. Heather Holly up to third, Katie Sylvester pinch running for Mirabli up to second, Lindsay Whittles at first. Isabel Holden to the plate with a huge opportunity. Isabel Holden getting a 114 on the season. That one is up high. Big opportunity here. 205 on base percentage for Holden. There's a strike. Blaine set the deal, infield playing in. Strike two. One and two. Due up next, Emily Whalen. Now, Isabel Holden going to have some words with Coach Murray. Coach Murray has done a fantastic job with this Hillers team in her first year as Hopkinton head coach, along with assistant coach Bruce Elliott. Spillane deals, there's strike three. Third strikeout of the game, well, technically fourth, but one of them reached on an error. So four strikeouts you can credit Emily Spillane with. Emily Whalen with a huge opportunity here. And we'll put this one on the ground up the middle. Gloved at short. Throw to second is going to be not in time. Everybody's safe and a run scores. Emily Whalen gets the job done, an RBI single. As Holly comes around, Rabley up to third, Whittles up to second. Poor choice by the shortstop on that one. You have to go to first on that play, especially with the way her body was turned. But try to go to second too late, and that's what happens. As stepping in now, Lily Morningstar. Emily Whalen, the freshman, putting up some great numbers on the season, was at a 306 mark coming into the game. Also had seven RBIs, just got a huge one there. Up the middle, and it's dropped by the pitcher. Throw home, smart play. They do get the out at home plate, and that will do it for the bottom of the second, but not before the Hillers play to run. It's 1-0 Hopkinton as we head to the top of the third. HKM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate a pest problem, eliminate a pest problem. Call them at 508-366-1820 or you can find them online at wpcpest.com. Stepping in for Plymouth South, Hannah Bailey, the left fielder. Mirabli deals, fouled away. Set to deliver. There's a strike. 1-0 Hillers as they played a run in the bottom of the second. There's a strike, and that is going to be out number one. Rabley has struck out the last four hitters. Has six strikeouts overall. Sarah Eaton, the second baseman, coming to the plate. And this is hit in the air, foul out of play. 0-1. Rabley deals on the ground, up the middle. Short to first, not a pro. Wait a second, she dropped it. At the last second, Isabel Holden dropped it, and Eaton reaches on the error. That'll bring up Caroline Loransky. Swinging strike. Excuse me, Caroline the Ranger. Rabley deals. Strike two. Rabley delivers. Strike three. Throw to first. Almost got her. But she is back safely. Two outs. Danielle Arranger to the plate. Two Arrangers on the Plymouth South squad as that one's bunted foul. Nearly fielded by Emma Murphy. Runner on first for Plymouth South. Two outs. Rabley delivers, fouled away. 0-2. Well, with the 0-2 count, I'm expecting Rabley to bring the heat right here. There it is, strike three. And that is going to do it for the top half of the third. To the bottom of the third we go, the Hillers leading Plymouth South 1-0. Bottom of the third inning, the Hillers coming back up to the plate, up 1-0 on Plymouth South. Stepping in, Katie Hawley, the second hitter in the lineup. 2, 3, and 4 due up. Katie Hawley, Molly Bennett, Kate Wilzell. Lineup and the pitch. Hit in the air. It is a high fly ball to center field, and it is handled by Danielle Arranger for the first out of the inning. I'll bring up Molly Bennett. Catch there by LaRanger, had a battle of the sun a bit. Pitch to Bennett, and this one's in the air on the left side and nearly gloved by the third baseman, but just out of her reach in foul territory, 0-1. Up and the pitch. That one is going to go off of Bennett. Second hit batter from Emily Spillane. That'll bring up Kate Wilzell, who struck out her last time up in the second inning. And this is a liner caught by the shortstop. Great catch by Shannon Colbert. Two-way. Heather Hawley to the plate. She reached on an error her last time up. And this is a fly ball to shallow center. Ranging back to make the catch is Shannon Colbert for the third and final out of the inning. We will head to the top half of the fourth. The Hillers leading Plymouth South 1-0. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They're a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options. Hopkinton Drug is located at 52 Main Street. Top half of the fourth inning, a 1-0 Hillers lead as Plymouth South coming back up to the plate to 2, 3, and 4 hitters. As Shannon Colbert takes strike one from Bree Mirabli. Shannon Colbert, Jessica White, and Abigail Conley do up. That pitch down low, 1-1. Senior captain awaits the pitch. The bunt is foul. 1-2. So far, it's been a bit of a pitcher's duel. In this one. Rabley deals. On the ground, left side foul. Count remains 1-2. Rabley deals, up the middle, glove by the third baseman, throw to first, not a problem. Good throw across the diamond by Emma Murphy. One away, and that'll bring up Jessica White. Rabley deals. And this is a liner, and that is going to get past the dive of Molly Bennett into center field. That's a single for White. That breaks up the no-hitter, and Abigail Conley will come to the plate. Rabley deals. There's a strike. 0-1. That went up high. One and one. Pitch to Conley. Strike two. Throw to first. Runner back safe. Rabley delivers. There's strike three. Throw to first. We'll get into right field, and the runner is going to advance to second. The throw in will not be in time. An errant throw from behind home plate by Welzel, but in any case, out number two is Conley struck out. Alyssa Dillon will come to the plate now. And this is hit in the air. Little chopper that is going to be handled by Molly Bennett, no problem. And that will be the third and final out of the top of the fourth. To the bottom of the fourth we go. Hopkinton leading Plymouth South in South Division I playoff action, 1-0. Bottom of the fourth inning as the Hopkinton Hillers come back up to the plate. Bree Mirabli to lead things off. Been a nice pitching duel between Bree Mirabli and Emily Spillane. And the first pitch in there for a strike. Mirabli walked her only time up in this game in the second inning. Spillane deals, and that's fouled away. 0-2. 6, 7, and 8 due up for the Hillers. Bree Mirabli, Lindsay Whittles, and Isabel Holden. Emily Spillane set to deal. And this is crushed into center field, but playing deep and making the catch is Danielle LaRanger. And she covers a lot of ground out there in center field in a short amount of time. And that'll bring up Lindsay Whittles. As the lefty awaits the pitch. There's strike one. Oh and one on Whittles. Upstairs, one and one. Whittles, a junior, 298 on the season. Sixteen runs scored. Is that one up high? Eight RBIs. Also three triples. Pretty good season at the plate for Whittles. And this is hit into right center. That'll drop down and roll all the way to the fence. Around first base to second. And now maybe to third. The throw to third is very much in time. And I do not know why she went past second base. But Whittles is out heading to third. And there is an injury on the play. Looks like the third baseman, Alyssa Dillon, took some contact from Whittles on that one. But a good piece of hitting, but double thrown out at third, two away. But that ball was in as she was going to third. The cutoff man had it. Easy throw to third. Could have had one runner in scoring position with one out. Now Isabel Holden will come up to the plate. We'll see if that affects the Hillers down the line. Spillane set to deal. Fouled away. Blaine delivers, and this is hit in the air and handled on the right side for the third and final out of the inning. As we head to the top of the fifth, it is Plymouth South 0, the Hopkinton Hillers 1 here on HCAM. Top of the fifth inning, a 1-0 lead for the Hopkinton Hillers, as we have a nice pitcher's duel here between Bree Mirabli and Emily Spillane. This game in the South Division I bracket between the 11th-seeded 13-7 Plymouth South Panthers and the 6th-seeded 17-3 Hopkinton Hillers. As Victoria Delf gets a piece of this one, third base side, Emma Murphy is not going to be able to reach it. 0-1. Emma Murphy is a very good defensive player on the left side of the field. He's really done a nice job at the third base position all season long for the Hillers. Mirabli deals. That one upstairs, 1-1. There's a strike, 1-2. Plymouth South led by head coach Stephanie Finn, assisted by Summer Yvonne and Chuck Goonan. Mirabli deals that one outside. 2-2 on Delf. It's the 6, 7, and 8 hitters for Plymouth South as that one's fouled away. Victoria Delf up now, Hannah Bailey and Sarah Eaton do up. Mirabli deals, and this is hit in the air to center field and handled nicely by Lily Morningstar. One away. That'll bring up Hannah Bailey. Hadley deals. There's strike one. To the set. Upstairs. One and one. Swinging strike, one and two. Nice warm day here at Hopkinton High School. Temperatures hanging around the high 70s. As this is hit in the air, foul territory and handled by Isabel Holden. And at first, it was looking like Bob Hamilton was going to have to catch that one, but fortunately, it stopped just short of us, and there's two outs. That'll bring up Sarah Eaton. And this is a liner, and it's going to be dropped by Emma Murphy. That was just an awkward ball to play, went right off of her glove. And Eaton reaches on a questionable single. He could rule it as an error as well. For now, give her a single. That'll bring up Caroline LaRanger. There's a strike. LaRanger struck out her last time up in the third. There's another strike. 0-2. Marably deals. Up the first base side. Fair ball, slow roller. Great job by Emily Whalen. Picking that up. Izzy Holden was waiting for it to roll to her. It stopped on the roll. Whalen was quick to react. Grab the ball and tag out the runner for the third out of the inning. It is 1-0 Hopkinton as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Bottom of the fifth inning. Emily Whalen will lead things off. It's the 9-1 and two hitters for the Hillers. Emily Whalen with a tremendous defensive play to end the top of the fifth. Came rushing over on a slow roller towards first base, picked it up and tagged the runner. Did it within seconds as Izzy Holden was just waiting for the ball to roll over, but it stopped suddenly and Whalen was quick to react. 1-0 on the lefty as the freshman standout steps back into the box and awaits the pitch. And this is lined and caught by the second baseman, Sarah Eaton. It was right to her. One away. And that'll bring up Lily Morningstar, the center fielder. Star 0 for 2 today. There's a strike. 0-1. Spillane is set to deal. The bunt and foul. 0-2. Blaine delivers, swinging strike, and that'll do it for Morningstar. Two away. Katie Holly coming up to the plate. It's the fourth strikeout for Emily Spillane. Up the middle, and it is gloved by the second baseman, and she could not get the throw off, but was able to get it to the shortstop. And unfortunately, her throw was a little bit too late, and Katie Holly is safe with the single. Molly Bennett now to the plate. It was a good job by Eaton, at least getting that ball to the shortstop to give a chance there. A good piece of hitting by Holly. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike one. Two outs, one on for the Hillers. It's Blaine Deals, swinging strike. 0-2. Up and the pitch upstairs. 1-2 to Bennett. Hillers baseball team, they ended their season with a loss to Stoughton in the first round of the playoffs. Great season overall, though, for head coach Jay Golden and crew. That one's fouled away. They finished 10-11 overall. But a lot of good young players on that Hillers baseball team. Splane set to deliver. That is upstairs, 2-2. But the baseball season not quite over for us here on HCAN. We'll be bringing you Ashland Legion baseball home games, as we've done for the past couple of seasons. We'll start up next week. The Ashland Legion baseball team should be pretty good. A lot of talented players from Ashland High School, Hopkinton High School, Holliston, and Bellingham, all joining forces to form Post 77. 2-2 on Bennett. All those games take place at the Ashland Middle School, all the home games. Certainly great to go and check out some good baseball over at Ashland Middle School, for those of you that have not been yet. This is hit in the air. This is going towards deep right center, but ranging over is the speedy Danielle LaRanger to make the catch for the third out of the inning. We'll head to the top of the sixth. Plymouth South 0, Hopkinton 1. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. You can find them online at WebsterFirst.com. Top half of the sixth inning is stepping in for Plymouth South is Danielle LaRanger. She'll be followed up by Shannon Colbert and Jessica White, the 1, 2, and 3 hitters for Plymouth South to face Bree Mirabli, who is on a roll today so far. And that bunt is foul. Nine strikeouts in today's game for Mirabli. There's a bunt, which is nicely caught by Kate Wilzell. One away. Shannon Colbert to the plate. Believe it or not, Plymouth South down to their final six outs. We are already just cruising along in the top of the sixth as the clouds start to roll in. No rain expected, however. That pitch up high. Line up and the pitch. That's fouled away. For those of you just joining us, you're tuned in to Hopkinton Hillers playoff softball. Hillers competing in the South Division I bracket. It's their first game of the postseason against 11th-seeded Plymouth South. Mirabli deals. That one is just up high. So far, it's a 1-0 game in favor of the Hillers. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. Winner of this game will play tomorrow against Walpole. Weather could be an issue tomorrow as this one's hit in the air. Emily Whalen ranging over to make the catch. And the defense so far getting the job done for the Hillers. Nice job by Whalen on that catch. And Jessica White will come up to the plate with two outs. Yeah. Grabley deals. There's a strike. Oh and one. There's 0-2. That one is fouled away. Count remains 0-2. This is hit in the air to center field and ranging under it to make the catch, Lily Morningstar, for the third and final out of the sixth inning. To the bottom of the sixth we go, Hopkinton leading Plymouth South 1-0. Bottom of the sixth inning, a 1-0 lead for the Hillers in the first round of the playoffs over Plymouth South. Stepping in, Kate Welzel, the 4-5 and 6 hitters due up for the Hillers as this is chopped and that'll drop onto the infield dirt and roll into left field. It is a single for Welzel. That'll bring up Heather Hawley. The Hillers would love nothing more than a pair of insurance runs here in the bottom of the sixth. Spillane set to deal. And this takes a couple hops on the infield dirt, bobbled by the shortstop. Throw to first is going to be in time. So Hawley pushed up Welzel and was thrown out on the 6-3. That'll bring up Marabli. That one is in there for a strike, 0-1. Rabley reached on a walk in the second, flew out in the fourth, has really hit the ball well as of late. And this is hit in the air, right side, foul out of play. 0-2. Spillane set to deliver. Upstairs. Hit in the air and foul. Out of play. Count remains 1-2. Blaine set to deal. Down low. Blaine delivers, fouled away. Been a very fun pitching matchup this afternoon between these two teams. Emily Spillane and Bree Marabli both pitching very well. And this is hit in the air, a high fly ball to shallow right field. Ranging back is the second baseman. She's able to make the catch. Sarah Eaton making the catch there. Two away. They'll bring up Lindsay Whittles. Whittles, 1-for-1, also was hit by a pitch. She had a double in the fourth inning, but was thrown out going to third. That one outside. Spillane delivers upstairs. Zell back to the bag, just safe. She was halfway down a base path after that last pitch. Spillane delivers inside, got away, and Wellzell is going to take off for third on the pass ball. Two outs, runner on third for the Hillers. Whittles with an opportunity to add some insurance. Spillane delivers. There's a strike. 3-1. If Whittles reaches, Isabel Holden due up. And this is hit foul, 3-2. Spillane set to deal. On the ground, up the middle, glove by the second baseman, throw to first, not a problem. A quick 4-3 ground out. And that will wrap up the bottom of the sixth. We head to the top of the seventh. The Hillers are up 1-0, and Plymouth South down to their last three outs. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Weston Nurseries, located on 93 East Main Street. Visit their garden centers in Hopkinton or Chelmsford. Discover limitless possibilities to create your backyard paradise. You can find them online at westonnurseries.com. Top half of the seventh inning, a 1-0 Hillers lead in the first round of the playoffs over Plymouth South. And the Panthers down to their final three outs, relying on their 4, 5, and 6 hitters. As Abigail Conley, the designated player, set to step in and face Bree Mirabile. Line up and the pitch, and this is hit in the air. A high fly ball to center field, and it is handled by Morningstar. That one was towards the warning track. That'll bring up Alyssa Dillon. So one away in the top of the seventh. Rabley deals their strike one. Dillon has struck out and lined out. There's another strike. 0-2. Rabley deals, fouled away. Rabley set to deliver, that's fouled away. That one upstairs. And that is strike three, tipped into the catcher's glove, two away. Tenth strikeout for Mirabile as Victoria Delph, the last hope for Plymouth South, steps in, and there is strike one. This game has really just been moving along so far. 68 minutes old. There's strike two. And the Hillers one strike away from advancing to host Walpole tomorrow. There it is, strike three, and the Hopkinton Hillers have advanced as they will get the 1-0 victory over Plymouth South. A great pitching performance once again from Bree Mirabile. and just a great pitcher's duel in general, as Emily Spillane also did quite a nice job for Plymouth South, but they come up short as they were not able to get a run across. Plymouth South had no runs, two hits, and one error, while the Hopkinton Hillers ended up coming up with one run on five hits and committed two errors. Bree Mirabli goes the entire length of the game. She just did a tremendous job on the mound. 11 strikeouts overall, and also the defense played a huge part today as well. Your player of the game is Bree Mirabli, as the Hopkinton Hillers advance to host Walpole at home as they take down Plymouth South 1-0 in the first round of the South Division I playoffs. For Bob Hinton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for watching Hopkinton Hillers softball here on HCAM. The final score for the final time, the Hillers defeat Plymouth South 1-0. Enjoy the rest of your day, everybody, and thanks for watching HCAM.